It's a cartoon for children. What are they getting wrong here? What do you think is the missed opportunity? State the case.
Let me first of all start by saying I think it's diabolically ignorant of any parent or adult to miss the essence of the backlash that Toy Story is facing. The essence being that children deserve to have a representative, teachable moment of their lived experience. Look, we know toys don't talk. We know they do not fly and they sure as heck don't jump out of buses, right? But entertainment must always have a moralistic or a moral intrinsic value. Animation of fictional characters take on human characteristics for a reason. To tell a moral story of good overcoming evil, of overcoming, you know, against the odds.
I think people have missed the point of Toy Story, right? It's a story about toys. I think if you think the story is about Andy and Bonnie, then you've missed the point of Toy Story. Mm. It's a story about toys. It's about Mr. Potato Head. It's about Buzz Lightyear. It's about Woody. It's about their adventure. And in this one, it's about Forky. It's about a single-use plastic fork trying to get back to the trash. If we're talking about a teachable moment, the teachable moment should be about sustainability. Mm. When we watched it, my daughter picked up on, hold on, why is Forky trying to get back to the trash? Shouldn't he be trying to get back to the recycling? Mm. And she picks up on these things. She loves The Princess and the Frog. She loves Moana. She loves those films. She likes watching things that she's reflected in. But she also picks up on things like sustainability and recycling.
Would you have liked to have seen a character, a more diverse character?
But we had voice characters by Jordan Peele and Ali Mackie, who are actors of colour, who voiced the characters that are in Toy Story 4. I think I saw a diverse range of characters. I did see a single-use plastic for it, and I thought, hold on, Disney, Pixar actually maybe missed a point to teach us about sustainability. And I think we should be focusing on live action films where you have 2 out of 10 leads are actors of color, and only 33% of those leads are women. That's where we should be focusing, not on Toy Story 4.
Okay.
And it's unfair to place all this weight on a series that's been around for 20 years.
Goodness sake, we live in a society that today teaches sex education and LGBT to our kids. Why aren't you all screaming, oh, they're just children? The reason they do this is because it is the right thing to do. Why? Because we need to start a much more progressive and transformative society. Why in God's name would you expect less from cartoon characters, which are meant to imbibe human characteristics for a reason?
I love Toy Story,
right? Yeah. I think it's all lovely and pushy. But you know what? Even my children, I've got a 13-year-old, 9-year-old, and 7-year-old. They expect more. When they watch things, they actually challenge the decisions made by characters. I'm saying, look, Pixar, you can do better.
Mm. But Disney Pixar are doing better. They have Princess
They can do better
We did contact Disney Pixar about this. We yet to see a reply, unfortunately. It's a really interesting debate. Sadly, we're out of time. We haven't got enough time for it now. We need to probably keep going and have it.
But just finally, is Little Bo Peep a feminist icon? Or is she, unfortunately, a product of an essentially sexist society?
She's a toy.
Right.
OK, can I just say... let me help you out with that. Is she a feminist icon? If we understand that feminism is about women's rights and women being able to make whatever choices they want without anybody judging them, as far as I'm concerned, every woman then is a feminist. We should be able to make whatever choices without you judging.
I haven't seen it yet, but I tell you what, I'm going to see it in a totally different way now.